Get up! Get up! Get up, get up, get up, get up! Get up! Yes, it hurts, but Jesus is the mender of broken hearts. Yes, it's confusing, but Jesus makes the crooked places straight. Yes, a lot of time has gone by, but Jesus is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Stop your weeping, stop your mourning, get out of your feelings. Jesus is here and he's calling you to get up. You gotta put your trust in his hand and get up from that situation. Get up from that moment. Get up from that season, because you are not done. Yes, it died. Yes, it's stinking. Yes, it's lifeless, but there is one who has conquered death, hell, and the grave. And though he has delayed his coming for a season, he is now here and he just calls your name to get up. Cast down the spirit of the zombie. I ran over to the dictionary to look up zombie, and something quickened in my spirit when I read the definition. The definition is a person given the semblance of life, but mute and willless. I'm talking to some people who have simply been functioning like a robot from day to day, with a memorized routine giving off the semblance of life. But if you be honest, that last blow left you muted and willless. That last no, that last failure, that last mistake, that last rejection left you for dead. We cast down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bring into captivity every thought to the disobedience of Christ. Can I submit to you today prophetically that the greater the problem, the greater the miracle? I said the greater the problem, the greater the miracle. The miracle that Jesus performed for Lazarus was the greatest miracle he had ever performed. It was something the world had never seen. Can I submit to you today that God's delay could be his divine setup for you to do something for and through you that the world has never seen? Do I have any faith walkers? Let me take a sidebar right here and encourage you to get rid of the people around you who are glorying in your weeping. Stop trying to make excuses for them. Stop trying to see it a different way. It is what it is. Holy Spirit has shown you several times, if I can't trust you to carry me when I'm weak and weeping, then I don't need you. I don't need you. That in order to get the miracle, there are some things that you've got to do. The first thing you got to do today is get out of the dark. I went through a season where I struggled with rejection and depression. One thing I learned about the enemy is that in order to keep you bound, he tries to keep you away from the light. He wants to keep you in the dark. What is light? The word of God. Positive people, positive influences, words of knowledge, words of wisdom. We have to remove that hard wall that we placed over our heart. We have to remove that hate. For some of us, the first thing we need to do is remove the stone. We got to remove that hate, and we got to remove that fear. We got to get rid of all those stones that are preventing the light of God from entering our situation. Psalms 119:105 says, your word is a lamp for my feet and a light to my path. Can I submit to you today that before you can live again, you got to choose to remove the stones?